The second St. Ledger Half Marathon, Sunday the 24th of April 1983, and over 4,000 runners have gathered at Doncaster Racecourse to register the names, pin on their numbers, and take part in Doncaster's biggest ever sporting event. It was an event sponsored by the Nottinghamshire Building Society and organised by Tick Hill Lions with the aim of raising £25,000 for the Eye Laser Appeal Fund at Doncaster Royal Infirmary.
Yeah. He's got to park on the apex of that, back on, because the nut is reading back on the clock.
Right.
So that the runners will see it as they approach.
Right,
okay.
Yeah, fair enough.
It was the sort of day when bus drivers gave up their Sunday mornings and South Yorkshire Transport laid on over 50 buses to ferry the runners to the start at nearby Rossington.
Hello, are you waving somebody off?
Yes.
Who is it?
My husband.
Has he run any one of these before, a marathon?
Half marathons, yes.
What, last year's?
No, he ran in the Lincoln 2 weeks ago.
Where did he come?
Oh, I don't know his number, it was about 1 hour 34.
But you're expecting him back in good condition, are you?
Yeah, yeah. He's got a gammy knee at the moment, but he's okay for running. But it might take him a slightly bit, you know, slightly longer.
Yeah, okay, thanks a lot.
On your way, Mick.
Okay. Have you run in a marathon before or a half marathon?
Well, this in fact is my second. I ran 2 weeks ago at Lincoln. Now, you're going to ask me where I came, aren't you?
Yes.
I have no idea.
But you finished the course, did you?
I finished in just under an hour and a half. I was very pleased with that, but as to where I came, I could not tell you at all. It was pouring. It's a lovely day today, but Lincoln was another matter altogether.
Are you hoping for a good result today? Have you been training hard?
Oh, I've got a terrible cold, and my knee's really giving me jip. It's the art of the preemptive excuse, is it? Rossington, the start of the 13.2-mile course, and for some runners, time to get down to the serious business of preparation.
What do you do with that cream?
I'm just rubbing it on to clear it. I've got a bit of a cold, so it's cleaned the nasal area, and also warm the muscles up to start with.
I see, so you're putting on your legs.
That's right, yeah.
I told you about unusual features. Don't be surprised if you see a dragon, will you? It's brothers Ralph Moore of Windsor Hill, Moses Stuart Doubles. Don't worry if you see this 30-foot dragon. Just jump on his back and catch a lift for a short time. That'll slow him down. And that was for
Meanwhile, some 5 miles up the course at Tick Hill, preparations of a different sort are underway. Roads have to be closed, traffic diverted. But as it's all part of a special occasion, no one seems to mind. Tick Hill is also the first of the three drink stations, and a small army of eager volunteers has been enlisted to set out thousands of plastic cups and fill tanks with hundreds of gallons of lovely water. And that gentleman, out for an early morning stroll with his young son, is a famous Tick Hill resident. Richard Lum, the Yorkshire cricketer. Meanwhile, back at Rossington, it's time for the final warm-up.
I'm hoping the public will put some money in as I run past with my dustbin.
So are you having this bin strapped on your back? Is that how you're going to do it?
Yeah, it goes on my back and I go all the way around with it.
Can you show us how it works?
Yeah.
We reckon that between 5.5 and 6 million
there we are,
tons
13 miles.
Looks
well,
jolly,
that's an optimistic approach.
As they run the 13
yes,
well, you're expecting to finish the course, are you?
Yes, I am. I ran in similar fashion at Nottingham last November, and the public in Nottingham gave about £300 altogether in the bin. So I had to stop at it a number of times.
It got heavy at the end, didn't
it? It got pretty heavy.
And I'll tell you something, if people put £1 coins in instead of £1 notes, you're going to be in real trouble, aren't you?
Oh, well, I'll accept any number of £1 coins, don't worry.
Okay, well, I'll start things rolling.
Thank you very much indeed.
Okay, best luck.
The first three to finish in every section will be given a prize, and they've been sponsored by a lot of people at 10p a pound weight loss.
Have you run in a marathon or a half marathon before?
No, this is first time, yeah.
So what makes people enter marathons?
I think it's satisfaction, you know, knowing that you know, you've done 13 miles or you've done 26 miles and you can actually just do it. And of course there's a fitness side to it as well. You know, it's a good way of keeping fit, I think. And so, you meet so many people. That's right.
Have you just met Jane?
No. I've known Jane for a few years. But,
so is Jane here to keep her eye on you?
That's right, you see, yes.
Because we hear about people meeting people in marathons, don't we?
That's right, yes.
It being the start of a long romance.
No, she's checking up on me. That's the only reason why she's running, really.
Is it?
Not really, no.
Can I ask you, all the athletes, please, just to ease back. What do you mind? Easing back a little bit.
And this is the colourful scene at the start. Over 4,000 runners of every shape and size. The biggest turnout for the race that Doncaster has ever seen.
10.
Hey. Steady on.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hey!
And they were off. A tremendous flood of colour, laughter and excitement, much to the delight of the thousands of spectators who turned up to cheer them off. And bringing up the rear of the field, members of Doncaster's blind community and their sighted partners, led by Jane Stapleton and Keith Leslie. Many of them experienced road walkers and looking forward to this 13-mile course. 4 minutes into the race, and the front of the pack is already on the outskirts of Rossington. Leading at this stage is last year's winner, 30-year-old Don Vagel from Norton near Doncaster. And behind him comes that long, long, steady stream of runners. Tucked in closely behind Don Vagel are Roy Bailey in the yellow vest, a 32-year-old from Swallownest, and in the green shorts, 27-year-old Trevor Hawes, a social sciences researcher from Leicester University. 18 minutes gone, and the leading runners have broken away from the rest of the field. But the opening pace has proved too much for Don Vagel. He's dropped back to third place, leaving these two, Roy Bailey and Trevor Horse, to battle it out at the front. The pleasant South Yorkshire town of Tickhill from the air, 5 miles from the start, another 8.5 to the finish, and the scene of the first drink station. And as the race cars pass through, it's Trevor Hawes, a Welshman who runs for Swansea Hornets, clearly in the lead at this stage, with Roy Bailey in second place and Don Vagel still in third place. Most of the leading runners didn't stop for a drink at Tickhill, but plenty of others did. After all, it was a hot day, and the sight of so much water must have been a temptation too great to resist. And when the main body of the pack came through, it was carnival time, and the crowd loved it. There were runners in fancy dress. Attractive girls to cheer on. And to the surprise of many, a wheelchair entry, right up there in the top half of the field. And for those runners who couldn't spare the time to stop for a drink, a couple of hose pipes turned on by some thoughtful residents. And it was at this point, when the carnival left Tickhill, after a taste of the cheers and excitement of a big race, that the joy of the occasion started to shine through, as bright and sunny as the spring sunshine itself. Thirty-nine minutes gone. As the runners are still streaming out of Tickhill, Trevor Hawes is already at Wadsworth, or Wadworth, or Wadsworth, as it's known to anyone born south of Retford. Roy Bailey's still there in second place, but he's dropping behind now, and Trevor Hawes has a good lead of about 150 yards. Meanwhile, at the rear of the field, there's an altogether more relaxed atmosphere.
Hello. You enjoying it, Dave?
Yeah, don't make it.
Dragon money!
Dragon money.
Support your local dragon.
Have we got volume?
Yeah?
I know you.
Me?
I know you. We work at Clumps.
Oh, God.
Sorry, David's friend.
Don't get me bored.
I'll give him the curtain, shall I? Well,
go on, then.
Hello.
No prizes for spotting the deliberate mistake.
Are you enjoying it?
Yes, thanks. Great. Do you like?
You've got to what?
We video wedding.
Oh.
Sorry, George.
Right on, baby.
You enjoying it?
Yes.
Did you get to end?
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, I'm 64 enjoying it. How's that?
Only 64?
Yep.
That's not bad going then.
No. What a lovely day for a run.
Beautiful, isn't it?
What's the problem?
Just filling that pothole there.
Pothole?
You're right.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. There's one ambulance calls coming up, hang on.
Yeah. Hello, Alan.
Hello, Bob. How you feeling?
Not so good.
You're
right. Keep going, man.
About 2 miles training.
Okay.
Serves me right. It's second year running this.
You're doing right. Come on, keep going. We'll let this car go.
Trevor Hawes on Tick Hill Road with 10 miles of the course completed. Roy Bailey, still in second place, can't keep up with the blistering pace and continues to lose ground. From here on in, it's going to be crowded streets with cheering people, and more cheers are bound to spur him on.
Run for home, run as fast as I can.
us to stare at each other. Our balloon with them screamed at the moon. Behaved like a fool, but I soon discovered.
Carhouse Road. From here, it's a straight run to the racecourse. And here it is from the air. There's a huge crowd waiting to witness the spectacle. Lots more cheers for Trevor's as he approached the end of Carhouse Road, with the racecourse stand in sight. He's been in the lead since Hesley, just before Tickhill, and he doesn't look to be in the mood to give it up at this age. At the racecourse, the excitement is growing. The crowd have been kept well informed with events by mobile radio links around the course. Here he comes to a tremendous reception. 27-year-old Trevor Hawes, the first runner home in the St. Ledger Half Marathon in a winning time of 1 hour, 7 minutes, 49 seconds. Well done, a splendid effort. And coming home to an equally warm welcome, Roy Bailey, second runner home in this year's St. Ledger Half Marathon.
How did you find the shorts?
Excellent.
Hot day for it.
It was a little warm. The crowd were incredible, very well organised. I think you can always tell when you go to a race and it's organised by a runner. John Wetton, that's superb. You know, he did very, very well.
And here's the man in third place, last year's winner, Don Vagel.
Great. 10 times better than last year.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
They cheered you on the day.
Definitely. Kept me going that.
Yeah, you enjoyed it?
Really, yeah. Yeah. I'm a bit jid.
2430 is Seahouse. So we can give you. Carling is in. Cricket
Yes, sir.
May I ask how old you are, sir?
55.
Yes?
Yeah.
And you are a granddad, are you?
I am, yes. Three times over.
Yes?
Yeah. Well, I enjoy it, you know.
Were they out there cheering you on today?
Oh, yeah, it's great. Great atmosphere, you know. And I enjoy it.
Did you run last year?
I did, yes. Yes. It's all about the same place, you know. But I enjoy it, and that's what it's all about.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah.
It was a nice day, but was it too hot for you?
A little bit. I kept having to wet all my neck, because, you know, as you get older, you find that the heat comes too quicker, you know, so it was a matter of keeping the old legs going, a bit of cold round the neck.
What were the other competitors like? There some very flamboyant ones, weren't they?
Oh,
Dragon and...
Oh, they're quite humorous, you know. And they're a part of the event, you know. Without them, I don't know what we'd do. It's so enjoyable, you know.
So you had a laugh on the way around with them,
did
you?
Oh, it's great, and all modesty, you know. I really enjoy it.
What's your name, by the way?
Eddie Kirkle.
OK.
There were many stories that day and many tales to remember. But for most people, the most outstanding memory was that of 31-year-old Keith Thompson of Sheffield, who staggered towards the line with his legs turned to jelly, refusing all help from the St. John's Ambulance volunteers. Keith fell time after time, but as his fellow runners streamed past him, many shouting encouragement, he somehow found the strength to struggle to his feet and keep going, all the time urged on by the cheers and the applause of this huge crowd. But would he make it? At this stage, few would have believed it. But then he raised himself up Lazarus-like for one final effort. And while Keith was still struggling to keep body and soul together, in came Eleanor Adams, the first lady home. Congratulations and well done to her. Meanwhile, back with Keith, and he's discovered that the only way to make sure of finishing is to enlist the help of another set of limbs. And it was just like this, on all fours, that this very courageous man inched his way towards the finishing line. Just 10 yards to go for Keith Thompson, and a huge cheer to salute his remarkable persistence.
What was your time today?
I think I missed the clock. I think it was running 28, actually. I know in 28. I think the crowd enjoyed themselves, actually.
And what inspired you to dress like this?
After London, I decided to have fun in here as well.
That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, just fun, anyway. You got lots of crowd around, suddenly that's all.
And whereabouts are you from?
Italy.
You're from Italy?
Yeah, indeed.
What's your name?
Franco.
Yeah. Okay, Franco. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Make sure that you put your hands on the shoulders of the fellow in front and you won't lose your place. Move down the fours as fast as you can. We're starting to clock just a little bit.
Hello, what's your name?
Birdman.
Birdman?
Yeah.
Can you just take your mask off so we can hear us?
Yeah.
You look a bit hot on them,
man. Yeah, well, not too bad, actually.
Was it a good run?
Yeah, I enjoyed it. Yeah. Clapping me all the way, yeah.
Now, why are you dressed like this? Is it for a particular purpose?
Well, I've got a nickname as Birdman at the local club, and I thought it might as well play it to the limit, so I've got my Alcatraz Rose on this vest on as well, so...
Are you doing this for charity?
Yeah, I've got a bet on with a pub landlord, and I think he'll pay me a fair bit to children's homes.
Hello, actually. It wasn't too bad this year. Well, struggling on this last couple of miles.
Oh, yeah.
Legs were going.
How was that?
Not enough training. 9 pints of Lombro last night.
That's it. What was that?
9 pints of Lombro last night.
Too much beer. Did you too much beer last night?
Yeah.
I bet you've written it off now, though, haven't you?
Definitely. And I'm just going to put it back on.
Okay.
All right.
Thanks a lot.
Cheers. 19.
I've got it the other way.
Yeah.
You're the first wheelchair home, aren't you?
Yes, I am indeed.
What are your arms like?
Not too bad, it's my back and it's aching a bit.
Is that yes. What it gets you in the back?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you have to do special training?
Well, I play wheelchair basketball, but I do a certain amount of road training, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And it's your back and your arms and it's straight?
It is, yeah. Well, it's not that, it's just that when you're in a wheelchair, well, it's more comfortable if your wheelchair is slightly curved backwards.
Yeah.
Well, in a racing chair, you've got to have it sitting up straight, so my back's aching a little bit, but apart from that, I feel all right.
Did you go around last year?
Yes.
Did you?
Yeah.
Where did you come last year?
I won it again last year.
Did you? Yeah. First
wheelchair again, yeah.
Chair home, yeah. Smashing.
Lovely.
What was it like?
Oh, it's very good. Very, very good. Mind you, I think it's a little bit too hot today, but...
Yes, it struck me as being a bit hot.
There seem to be more people out this year than last year as well.
Yes, I think there are, actually. There's 2,500 last year. I think it's between 4,000 and 5,000 this year.
Yeah, yeah. It's been very good. It's been very good indeed.
Are you going to enter next year?
Oh, yes, certainly, yes.
Smashing. What's your name?
Alan Robinson.
Fine. Okay, well, thank you very much, Alan.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thanks very much indeed. Thank you.
That's a very colourful outfit. Do you wear this all the time?
No, it was a fancy desk party last night, and it was a little bit... I said if they sponsored me for charity, I would run like, you know.
So you haven't been to bed? You've come straight from the party?
No, I've been to bed, but I didn't sleep very well, because I like sleeping with a hedgehog with these curlies in back and that.
Yeah. Oh, you didn't put them in first thing this morning?
No, I made up last night, and all I did, I just plonked into bed and got what sleep I could, and then came here.
Mm. Have you been doing it for a bet?
No, just for charity, like, you know, I got some sponsors, then I got some more sponsors last night for coming like this. I'm going to run normally, you know.
Yeah, who does it go to?
Well, half goes to the Eye Lazy for Doncaster Hospital, and the other half goes to the Doncaster Subacca Club. We just built his own clubhouse and he's trying to get it on its feet.
Smashing.
So, half goes to there.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, very good. It's the first time I've run one and I've done quite well.
How did you feel? Happy. You look in good shape, actually.
I am. I haven't done as much training as I would have liked. I've run very well.
Yeah.
But with it being the first marathon, you don't really know how fast to start.
Yeah.
So I just took it steady the first half and felt good and then just did as hard well as I could on the second half.
Smashing. What's your name?
Parks. Ken. Ken Parks.
Ken Parks. Okay, Ken. Well, thanks a lot and congratulations.
Thanks very much.
However, for some people, the unusual heat proved to be a cunning enemy. And the small St John's ambulance post behind the finish was kept fairly busy. But most of the cases were mild ones, and only 7 people had to go to hospital for further treatment. Another problem, of course, was blisters.
So this is what you put on the feet, is it, baby powder?
Well, it's very soothing, isn't it? And I mean, if you put anything between the towels, it's a bit difficult. It does rub, so if you put a bit of talc on, it cools it, and that's as much as you can do, really. Otherwise, big blisters, then you've got to treat anyway.
How many pairs of feet do you think you'll have treated before the day's out?
Quite a few.
And still they streamed in. Fancy dress entries, runners in desperate search of a drink, patriotic entries. And even the odd unofficial canine entry, would you believe? And of course, enter the dragon. 6 likely lads from Conisborough having just the time of their lives.
Going, please. Keep going.
And here's a face we all know, Simon Brister, the solicitor from Nottinghamshire who raised a small fortune in coppers for the Save the Children Fund. I say, don't look now, but there's a couple of strange men following you. Now, where have we seen that bonny baby before? Yes, it's that deliberate mistake again.
You okay? Make it.
Oh, can I have a chat with you?
Yes, you certainly can, yes.
Now, what's your name?
Bill Burns.
And are you the oldest runner in the race, Bill?
I'm the oldest runner in our club. I've been running since 1929.
Have you?
Yes. I started in 1929.
And how did you find it today?
I found it quite good up to the last mile, and I couldn't get a sprint.
Are you hoping to sprint over there?
Yes.
But you can't manage that.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
You did. You've got a sprint finish in, did you?
Yes, but it went very fast.
Where are you from, Rachel?
Doncaster.
What time did you get there?
1:52.
That's pretty good, isn't it?
Yeah, very pleased.
Is this the first time you've done a half marathon?
Yeah, the first time. But I'll do it again now.
You're going to next year, are you?
Yes. I really enjoyed it. It was just such an atmosphere. And everyone kept you going, when you got all the crowds and things, it was just great. It's really good.
And have you been running for charity?
Yes, I've run for the Razor Laser.
Yeah. And how much do you think you've earned?
About £40 if everyone coughs up. Oh, so I'm all right. Yeah, I'm really pleased.
Okay, well, thanks a lot, Rachel.
Yeah, pleasure.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
How did you do?
Had 2 hours, two.
Yeah.
Yeah, smashing.
So what sort of placing was that?
No idea at all.
But you were the first Dragon Home.
I bet we were, yeah. We're the only Dragon Home, I think.
Yes.
That would be many more pastors.
Are you doing it for charity?
Yes, we're doing it for charity. Yes. What? The Razor Laser.
Yes. And how much were you on, do you know?
I have no idea until we collect it all.
How were you actually sponsored? Was it per mile or to finish the course?
Per mile, most of it was per mile, yes.
Several donations.
Yeah.
And we'll be collecting right through to tonight, around the pubs. And the clubs.
Yeah.
And so we won't run until tomorrow.
So you're putting back some of that fluid that you've lost, haven't
you? Always
hope. Straight away.
But you look very fresh anyway, haven't you? How did you find it?
All right, no bother.
Yeah.
Well, Cam, that keeps you fresh, don't
you? You got a lot of support, didn't you?
Yeah,
very good. Excellent.
Smashing. Okay, well done, lads.
Lovely.
Thanks a lot, then.
Okay, thank you, man.
We made it! We won the 330 as well, you know. At Haydock Park. That was a big mistake.
First runner in the age group 7 to 39 was number 2842 in a winning time of 67.49. Swansea Harriers all the way from Bridge End. We've already had a word with them. Second place runner, and in third place,
number 2863 in a time of 69.59.
Eleanor Adams, first prize for the St. Leger Half again this year. And in second place, 7016, C. Ryan. C. Ryan, 7016. 8,005, third place.
And while the victorious were collecting their trophies from Councillor Harry Schofield, the Mayor of Doncaster, the runners continue to pour in. Here's young Hayden Parker from Sandalwood School in intake, steering his wheelchair across the filling line and across the toe of a friend.
Don't lose this place.
All right. Okay, pal, take it easy. We've got through it. Can we take it down this way?
We've got you.
Followed by yet another wheelchair, number 0954, Mr. P. Walker. Well done. As well as wheelchair entries, there were also handicap runners like Peter Goldthorpe of Besica sprinting home to warm applause from the crowd. Runner 7014, Maureen Kirby, one of five rather mature schoolgirls running for St. Peter's Mothers Union, who were urged on by the promise of £400 for charity.
Well, congratulations. A very nice day for everybody concerned. Most people I spoke to seem to enjoy it. How did it go from your point of view?
Oh, thank you, Patrick. I think it's gone very well indeed. We got sunshine, we got sunshine, and I think the sunshine alone brings people out in the right spirit. It really brings tears to people's eyes, you know, when they seem to crawl across the finish after completing 30 miles. This is what it's all about. It's not to win, it's simply to participate and be one of 4,300 runners. I'm very privileged to be a part of it.
How many people actually been involved in organising this event?
If you're talking about marshals and St John's and police and the fire service and everybody else, you're talking about more than 1,000 people. In marshals alone, en route and at the start and at the finish, we've probably had 350 people out helping us. It is indeed.
Any idea how much you've raised for charity?
Well, we are optimistic to raise £40,000. If we make £40,000, you've got a very happy race coordinator on your hands.
It's a little on through. Come on, you've got 20 yards to go. Well done. Keep it going. 44.9, 44.10, 44.12, 44.13. Well done.
Can I have a quick chat with you? Hello, what's your name?
Jane Foster.
Jane, and what's your name?
Keith Lesnar.
Yeah. Jane and Keith. So what was it like all the way around?
Pretty good. Tiring, you know.
Did you run all the way?
No, no. We've walked until that last bit.
Yeah, you get a time before 3:45, so. Between
well, you've done it.
Spotify,
you've done it, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yes, smashing. Did you run last year?
No.
So this is the first time you've done a half
marathon? I've done this, yes, a half marathon. I have walked, walking 20 miles, yeah. South Yorkshire road thing. I walked that before.
What were the crowds like on the way around?
Very good, very good. They were
so
smashing.
You've had a smashing day.
Good encouragement, yeah. Yeah. Even from the people that got in before us and going home in cars, yeah. They were pipping the ultras and shouting to us to encourage us, so yes, very good.
That's fabulous.
Yeah.
Are you going to do it next year, if it runs next year?
Yes, if I'm fitting up, yeah, certainly.
You'll have to get in training and beat that time, won't you?
I'll be a year older than that makes it. Okay. In the over 40 to start with.
Right, thanks a lot, congratulations.
Thank you.
John, you're the race director. Congratulations, a marvellous event. Everybody I've spoken to has enjoyed it immensely. Mm-hmm. How did it go as far as you were concerned?
Well, extremely well. I'm responsible for making sure that all the technical aspects of the race are covered. And one thing that we have discovered is that whereas last year we had 2,300 people, we've got twice the number this year, but the difference is more than double.
Yeah.
In terms of handling people, busing them from here to the start, coping with them at the feeding stations and of course here at the finish. And I think we've all learnt something this time, but we must think even bigger next year for coping with all the problems that we do have. But on the whole, I'm very happy. Most people have enjoyed it. Most people who are critical really are being hypercritical, I think. Perhaps they couldn't find their baggage as quickly as they thought they would. Perhaps they had to queue a bit at the drinking stations, but these are problems that even the London Marathon faces.
Yes, what about the statistics of that? I mean, the drinking stations in particular, you must have got through a lot of gallons of something today. I don't know what it was.
Probably about 15 tonnes of water.
We
dispatched in about 30,000 plastic cups and 10,000 sponges. You know, incredible statistics, really.
Yes, where did they all come from?
Oh, here and there.
You borrowed a
yes,
few.
Yes, we borrowed a few from here and bought a few from there. Had some donated. The water was free.
Yes, well, it has been a marvellous day, and once again, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Now the end of a marvellous day, a really memorable day, as over 4,000 runners basked in the spring sunshine and brought joy to a crowd of over 50,000 people. It was a day of collecting memories as well as prizes. A fun run, a most human of races.